Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So today we got called out by one of our customers. So this one, this is it. So this one's not going far. I believe it's going like 10-15 miles down the road. We're with the medium duty now. I'm gonna see if we can pick it up with this. Should be able to. They didn't tell us it's gonna boom. It's one of those, what do you call these, landscapers. So we'll see what's going on with the truck, and let's go help them out. Let's take the phone. Oh, yeah, that's right. Keep forgetting my mask. Hey, what's going on? How you doing? So what's going on with it?
It died on the hill. It just died. I switched tanks like 5 miles back or less, right? And then it just died. Like, ran out of gas.
Well, it ran out of gas, or
it seems like it's not getting any fuel.
Gotcha.
The second tank is filled.
Huh.
You know, I make sure I see the pills, and when I switch to the second tank, it ran for a couple minutes, and then it died.
Gotcha. Alright, so just give me a few minutes, let me just load it up. Hey, what's up? So I just want to make sure you got the pictures. Yeah, I can do it. But this is not what they said it was. So just let me know how much more we're gonna charge them. Okay, just let me just put it on the notes and see what's up. All right, cool, thank you. Bye. So is it going to a shop?
Yeah, I thought it was going to your shop.
To my shop?
You know where it's going?
Oh, all I got is an address. I don't know if it's a shop. I don't know if it's...
whatever address that is. I don't know. It's a big company, man.
Okay, yeah. So 3892 First Street, Livermore. Unit B. I don't know exactly where that is.
Yeah, that's cool. You can just drop me up next to there.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to make sure that it's going to a shop or wherever it's going.
Yeah, it must be a shop.
Okay, cool. Because I got to drop the drive line. The drive line? So I have to take it off for me to be able to tow it. That's why I wanted to make sure it's going to a shop, because the shop has to put it back in.
Oh, I get you. Okay. Alright. Yeah, it's definitely going to a shop.
Okay.
Yeah.
Alright guys, so we're gonna put some cones out here. That way people see us. Do you have the keys in there?
Yep.
Okay. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and drop it in neutral for now. This thing seems really, really heavy. See how I went in the middle of the, what do you call this, lug nuts or studs? That way it doesn't damage my strap. Take care of that in a few. Oops. Always make sure get this boat that flew off. This does not slide out, so tie it up. Let's see if this one actually go up here. Yep. That's where it's gonna go. Thank you.
play usually takes me the most. I'm trying to find out if to take. I'm going to tie this up. This does not go through. Like I said, this is usually what takes me the most, trying to figure out where to go, how to do it.
Yep. All right, just get all the dirt out of my ear. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, we are all good to roll. Gonna take one last pick. There you go. Put the window up. Fit the vacuum park. Nice Tacoma. Anyways, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and I will see you guys at the drop. Ah, well, good to go, sir. All right, so we are here at the drop. So the shop just asked I can drop it right by the gate. So let's go ahead and back up, see how much room we got. Let's try to get in here. Go this way. I'm not gonna be able to unless I enter right here. I don't want to trap myself either. Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to. Not. There. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and drop it. That's the best I can do actually, because there I got cars in front of me. That's what sucks about these small shops. They give you no room. I could just go up there as well. Oh, never mind. They'll lock me up. So I got the customer inside talking to the shop. I'm just gonna go ahead and drop the vehicle. Take all the straps, the one underneath as well. And then head to my next call. I also got my dispatcher collecting payment right now. That way we can save some time. Oh my God, so crooked. I don't like this part. I don't like the way I parked. Let me get my lights out first before backing it up a little bit more. This thing is heavy. It moves my whole truck. Okay, yeah, go for it. Let me just do the receipt, because I guess your boss needs the receipt as well. My dispatcher is collecting payment right now, but I just want to make sure that I can give you a receipt.
Yeah, we can take care of the payment, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, no rush. I gotta wait for the Uber.
Oh, okay. That's one. Before we take the other one out, you gotta set the e-brake. That way it doesn't roll. Leave the key in there, and then turn the flashers off. Now we can take this out. Move forward. All right, in case the mechanic asks, the bolts that I took off the driveline, they're on the passenger side on the floor. There's a little baggie that I put them all in there.
Okay, yeah.
All right. It's always good to let them know exactly where you put the bolts for the driveline, because you don't want to get that call on your day off saying, hey, you remember doing this? Would you put the bolts for the driveline? Of course, I'm just going to tell them the usual spot, but they don't know, mechanic don't know what the usual spot is. So, just to save some time, just let them know. That way, the owner of the vehicle knows. Anyways, guys. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys on the next video.